Welcome to Writing an Outstanding Cover Letter, brought to you by Nova Scotia Works Employment Solutions Society. I'm Emily and I'll be your presenter today. Today we'll discuss an introduction to cover letters, types of cover letters, appropriate cover letter formats, some samples, submitting your cover letter electronically, and some additional tips. We'll also talk about thank you letters. So what is a cover letter? A cover letter is sent with a resume, and its purpose is to highlight those elements of your education, experience, and skills that most closely align with the specific needs of the prospective employer. It prompts the employer to read your resume. An effective cover letter is a sales pitch and should be clear, concise, positive, and to the point. A cover letter typically provides detailed information explaining why you're qualified for the job you're applying for. Effective cover letters explain the reasons for your interest in the specific business or organization and position and identify your most relevant skills and experiences. An effective cover letter will tell the prospective employer that you can do the job, the type of worker you are, and that you will work well with the existing team and environment. So what are the advantages of having a cover letter? A cover letter gives the employers a quick summary of your qualifications as to how they match their specific needs. It highlights your unique specific contributions that you would bring to the job, makes a positive first impression to help you stand out from the competition, and attracts and holds the interest of the hiring manager, inspiring employers to find out more about you from a resume and interview. Don't underestimate the importance of a good cover letter. There are multiple ways that cover letters may be written, and how you write it will be impacted by multiple factors, including whether you are responding to an advertised position, following up to a cold call, doing prospecting letters, this is when there's no advertised position, or writing thank you letters. Before you begin writing, gather as many of the following as possible. These will help you to best craft your cover letter. You will want the job description and advertisement, information about the company, your resume, any past performance reviews, letters, or contacts for references. You may also wish to have on hand your diplomas, degrees, and certifications. A cover letter should follow a specific format and include the following information: your contact information, the current date, the employer's contact information, a subject line, a salutation, that is a greeting, an opening paragraph, the body paragraph, and a closing paragraph and signature. Here is an example of how to properly format your contact information. You will see that all of the information previously discussed is here, and you can take a moment to look at the formatting. Here's some more on formatting. Take a look at how it is aligned, and you will want to ensure that you include the employer contact information, the name of the person to whom you're addressing the letter, the company name, and the full mailing address, a subject line, which should reference the competition or job posting, and title, if this information is available. If not, use a appropriate subject line, making it very clear what position you're applying for, and a greeting, such as dear so-and-so. And if you have the contact person's information, it is best to use their name. If you do not know, you can use dear hiring manager, to whom it may concern, or attention human resource manager. It's also a good idea, if you don't have the person's name who is doing the hiring, to go out of your way to get it. So a quick call to the company or organization to request the name of the person doing the hiring is usually all it takes to get that name. If for whatever reason you can't or don't want to do that, then these salutations such as dear hiring manager to whom it may concern or attention human resource manager are fine. But it's nice to go that extra step and get the name if you can. Now to the actual contents of the letter itself. In the opening paragraph, explain why you are writing. In the body paragraph or paragraphs, highlight your qualifications for the job. This is what you have to offer, your most relevant skills and experiences. In the closing paragraph, state your interest in a personal meeting and how you will follow up. Close on a positive note, such as, I look forward to hearing from you, or I hope to become a valuable member of your team. Here are some examples of appropriate opening paragraphs. Of course, you will see how they change based on the position and posting format. For example, this letter is in response to your advertisement for an administrative assistant as posted in the April 20th issue of the Halifax Chronicle Herald. My resume is attached for your review and consideration. Or, I am applying for the position of shipper receiver as posted at the Service Canada Centre in Bedford. My resume is enclosed for your review and consideration. Or, the enclosed resume is for your review and consideration. My primary interest is in the area of accounting and I would consider other related administrative positions that may be available. So you can see that it's good practice to reference how and where you heard about the position and say a little bit about why you were interested. Some sample examples of opening paragraphs when you are following up from a communication are: further to our telephone conversation of January 7th, 2023, concerning employment opportunities, I've enclosed a copy of my resume for your review. As mentioned, I have over 8 years' experience in this field and have direct skills in blank and blank. Further to our recent conversation, I have enclosed my resume as application for the position of such and such, as per your request, with a keen interest in sales and sound knowledge of your company. I'm very excited about this great opportunity. So what should be in the body paragraph or paragraphs, and how should you write it? Review the job advertisement, underlining every required skill and duty, and match these required skills with skills you possess. Be able to identify how you possess those skills through examples, references, and accreditations. Create one or more paragraphs that show the employer that you have the skills to do the job. It's also important to show you have enthusiasm and to let your personality shine through. Remember, you want to show that you're qualified and you want to stand out. The length of the body paragraph or paragraphs depend on the position you're applying for. The longer the list of required skills and training the employer is asking for, the longer the body of your letter should be. However, your cover letter in total should be no longer than a page. In your closing paragraph, you want to state your interest in meeting with the employer for an interview and arrange for further contact. You may want to briefly summarize the important points of the body of your letter using different wording. So we'll talk momentarily when we discuss submitting applications online why it's important to use the exact wording that is used in the job description at least some of the time. So since you'll have already done this in the body paragraph, it's okay to use some synonyms in the closing paragraph and kind of mix it up so you sound like yourself. Individualize it a little bit. So you want to make it easy for the person to contact you. So you may want to list your phone numbers and email address at the end, even though these are already on your cover letter, it's on your resume. You want to state them again. Just make it really easy for them to get in touch with you. Also use wording that shows you have confidence in your ability and thank the employer for their time and consideration. Here are a couple of examples. I am confident that I possess the skills, education, and experience required to become a valuable part of your team and would appreciate an opportunity to meet with you at your convenience. I can be reached at such and such a number. I look forward to receiving your call. Thank you for your consideration. Or I would like to meet with you to further discuss how my qualifications meet your specific needs. I may be reached at phone number, or you may leave a message. Here's an example of what your completed formatted cover letter is likely to look like. Take a few moments to look at this, and you may also get in touch with Nova Scotia Works Employment Solutions, as we have templates for cover letters that we would be happy to share with you. It's important to target your cover letter. Targeting your letter shows that you have taken the time and effort to craft a cover letter specifically for this position. It shows that you've taken the time, initiative, and it can even highlight your research, organizational, and communication skills. Targeted cover letters are written with a specific job in mind. You will want to use language that matches the employer's. It's a good idea to pick out keywords from the job posting and use them. Only include relevant information and customize the letter to match the information in the job advertisement to show that you're a good fit. So to review, a cover letter should include an opening paragraph in which you explain why you're writing, specify the position for which you're applying, quote the occupation, position, and reference number if given, state your interest in this position, or explain why you're contacting the company or organization. Note that your resume is enclosed or attached. It is often preferred that a cover letter and resume be melded into one document. So unless instructed otherwise in the job posting, do this. This can make filing and sharing correspondence easier for the potential employer. There are special considerations when you're submitting your cover letter electronically. When you're sending an emailed cover letter, it's important to follow the employer's specific instructions on how to do so. If there are no instructions, combine the cover letter and resume as an attachment. Make sure the subject line in your message clearly states the position you're applying for. When you apply for advertised jobs using email, you will need to know whether or not the employer wants the document as an attachment or in the body of the email. Perhaps the most important part of sending an email cover letter is to follow the employer's instructions. Not following instructions could result in your application not being considered. If you're instructed, send as an attachment. It's important to send your cover letter and resume attachments correctly and include all the information you need so your email message is read, and to let the potential employer know that they can contact you and schedule you for an interview. If the job posting says to include your cover letter and resume as an attachment, do so in Word, unless otherwise instructed. Now, there's a reason for that, and it is the same reason that we are recommending you use the exact wording as in the job posting to describe your skills and abilities. And that is because an increasing number of employers are using what is called ATS, or applicant tracking systems. These are computer programs that review the applications, the electronic applications, and screen in and screen out applications. By using a document type that is likely to be easily read by this type of system, like Microsoft Word, and by using the exact language that is being used in the job posting, you are more likely to be screened in by this electronic ATS system. If you are asked to put your application, your cover letter and resume directly in the body of an email, use plain text and don't use HTML. Keep it very simple, because if you use formatting, the recipient may not see your information in the same way that you do. Here are some more tips on how to format and create a great cover letter. Ensure your name and contact information match the style of your resume as far as font. You might want it to be a little bit larger and in bold, but ensure that the style is the same. Use the standard 1-inch margin border. Keep it to one page. As for abbreviations and acronyms, you should always first spell out the entire name. So for example, the Nova Scotia Community College, most people around here know that quickly as the NSCC, but don't use abbreviations without first spelling them out, even if they are common. So in the first reference, you would spell out Nova Scotia Community College, followed by NSCC in brackets, and subsequently you can just say NSCC because you will have already referenced it. Writing in this way shows you understand small but important rules of written communication. So let's review some important tips. Customize each cover letter. Target those cover letters. Don't repeat all the information in your resume in your cover letter. Write simply and clearly. Personalize your cover letter. Proofread carefully. Little errors can mean you lose out on big opportunities, so take care. Also, ask for help. Two sets of eyes are better than one, and three are even better. So you may want to ask a friend, family member, or Nova Scotia Works Employment Solutions Society employee to assist you in your editing. Many people don't even consider sending thank you letters, but this is a great way to stand out. It demonstrates good manners and a professional attitude, shows an appreciation for the employer's time. You can, in this way, reiterate your interest in the position and organization, and if there is any information that you have forgotten to say during the interview, you might be able to sneak it in there. So this is a great thing to do after a interview, and it can really help you to stand out from the crowd. A well-written thank you letter can make the difference between getting the job or not. Employers are sometimes in the position where they have more than one equally qualified candidate for the job and are having difficulty making hiring decisions. The individual who goes the extra distance and stands out from the rest is likely to be the successful candidate. We want to help you succeed. So thank you for being with us today, and feel free to reach out. To contact us by email with general inquiries, email info@empsolutions.ca. And to contact us regarding workshops and webinars, events@empsolutions.ca. And you can visit our website at www.empsolutions.ca and also our Facebook page at Nova Scotia Works. You can visit or call our locations in Bridgewater at 215 Dominion Street, phone number 902-543-2479, at our Chester location, 3785 Highway 3 in Chester, our Hubbard's location, 10 Richard Green Lane in Hubbard's, and our Liverpool location, 176 Main Street in Liverpool. And that phone number is 902-356-2039. Our toll-free number is 866-711-0411. And call ahead of time, especially for the Chester and Hubbard's locations, please. Thank you. please contact Nova Scotia Works Employment Solutions Society. Our mission is to enhance the employability of all individuals in our community through learning and inclusive services. This means we're here to help you. Feel free to come by our centers to pick up informational materials, ask questions, use our services and technology for your career search, and receive assistance from our helpful staff. We have many services available free of charge. All our services are free of charge to both registered and non-registered clients. These include regular presentations, both in person and online, on a variety of employment and pre-employment topics. You can access our computers, printers, and fax for job search purposes. And we can help you with assistance in many aspects of your job search, including creating your resume and cover letter and using our digital services. We can assist you with interview preparation, navigating career transitions, planning your career path, referrals to other helpful services and programs in the center and in the community, disability and accommodation supports, learning about local labor markets and how those impact you, accessing retraining programs, work experience programs, and exploration of entrepreneurship options. And consider registering for our case management service. Our case managers are dedicated, kind, respectful professionals who are eager to help you to realize your goal. Anyone can work with a case manager, and it's very useful. You and your case manager will be a team. You'll work together to create and implement a return to work action plan. That's what we call it, but you don't have to be returning to work. You can already be working and want to find a different job. Anyone can sign up with us as long as you're in Nova Scotia and are legal to work in Nova Scotia. Think of a case manager as a helpful guide who will assist you to determine and reach your goals. You're always empowered and in charge of the process. Even if you feel confident that you know how to job search, their assistance and support can be very valuable. Your case manager can help you determine if you're eligible for various funding programs that you may be interested in. They can also assist you to best navigate the application process. They even often know about jobs that are not posted publicly and can help you work out any uncertainty you may have regarding where you want to go and how best to get there. Even the best writers, including of resumes and cover letters, sometimes make little errors, and having that second set of eyes look over your documents and having someone to talk to about your goals is so helpful. So please sign up today or whenever is convenient for you. Give us a call or stop by and we will register you for an intake with a case manager.